Welcome to my new tutorial. Today I want to talk about a simple feature, or most people think it's a simple feature. I want to talk about how to build up a solution. It's not that complicated what I will show you today, but it's hopefully interesting to you, especially when you didn't thought about this issue a little bit deeper in the past. Okay. So what I wanted to show you is what are most people on the internet showing you, why this is bad in building up a solution, and how you could make it better. Let's try. Most often when I look at people at tech, at build or whatever, when they just create a little sample app, something like this happens. They just go to file new project. This is okay. And then they go to, let's say, console application, and they say, hey, my sample, and hit enter. And everybody's fine with that, and you're just looking at the code and concentrating on it. But if you think about it, what's happening here, you have to deal with two terms inside of Visual Studio. The first one is the term solution. The second one is the term project. So solution is a somewhat container for projects. This is the thing I clicked on right now. In this case, it's called my sample. The project, on the other side, is something which lives inside the solution and can be, one project of many projects inside your solution, and will be probably when you're working in professional business. So, for the first naming your solution as the same way you name your project isn't a good idea at all. So let's go a step further and say, hey, let's make a new project and call it my sample, but put it in a solution which is called my product. I do this because it's a good way to think about solutions as products, because when you think about it, your product is somewhat a container which consists of a lot of projects. So the solution equals to the product, and the project equals to one piece of your product, or whatever piece it is. For example, if you will be a developer at Microsoft, like, I don't know, 20 years ago, you would say my solution, my project is called Word, and my product is called Office. So my solution is called Office. Would be a good way. But let's do it a little bit more not so Microsoft-centric. My product. Okay, let's add it. Now we have another solution. Okay, it's called my product, so that's better. And inside lives a project called my project. So it's now easier to just add a new project, add new project, and call it, let's say it's a class library, my logic. Now it's more clear, because you have a product which consists of logic and something else. Okay, but there's still a problem. Even that the find new project dialog is giving us the opportunity now, which wasn't ever, to name the solution in a different way or different from the project. That's good, but we have still the problem that in real applications we would like to give the solution a much more nicer view and more order. And for doing this, we have something at hand which is called add solution folder. Solution folder is a different thing than this folder, add new folder. It's not called solution folder. And I will explain what the difference is soon. But first of all, let's try to do it. Add solution folder, and let's say we have one that's called logic, and we just hide our logic project there, and then you can add another one, for example, which is called UI, because this is an UI project, and you put it in there, and everything looks a little bit more straightforward. So then let's say I add to my project here a new normal folder, which is called utils, a very often used folder in my opinion. And now we have both kinds of folders, solution folder and a project folder. So what is the difference? First of all, they have different logos, but that's not very good visible right now at my solution, I know. But that's not the point. You can see the main difference when you go to the folder in the file system where your solution sits. Let's take a look. I have a tool, open folder in File Explorer. This comes, by the way, by VS Commands, a very cool extension. So anyway, so here you see the difference, the first annoying difference in the first place between folders, normal folders and solution folders. If I go to my project, I see that at the moment I created a utils folder inside the project, he created a file system folder too. But on the solution level, the UI and logic folder don't were mapped to file system folders, because solution folders are only considered as logical elements, not as physical elements in your solution. So if there's no folder in file system, so how does Visual Studio know to display them and to put something inside of them? That's all of this is done in the solution file itself. You can go, this is a solution file, the SLN. You go and open it with, for instance, Notepad++. And then you see that there is a logic and a UI element, which is a project, as the real projects are too. The difference is the GUID here. This GUID tells Visual Studio, hey, this is not a C# project or something like that. This is a folder. And now the projects, as I moved them into those folders, they can be put into you know, these logical folders. And that's how Visual Studio knows where to put them. So, okay, cool. But the point that there's no physical folder here is not the best one, because first of all, as you see, when you navigate through your file system, because for instance you search for some bin file inside this folder, which is what I do very often, it's not the same navigation as you do in the solution. I consider this not too good. The second point in this, and more important point, is a Team Foundation server, for example. What you can do in Team Foundation server is that you can map folders, for example this folder, you can give him an own security restriction in Team Foundation server. You could tell someone not to be able to check in or check out in the My Project folder. Wouldn't it be good if you have the same structure as in the solution to forbid someone to go into the UI folder and everything what's beneath this? That's not possible in TFS if you just use solution folders without corresponding file system folders, because TFS is not aware of these folders. They are only logical inside the solution. That's a reasonable point not to use this quick and dirty, oh, I do a solution folder and put something in it, because that's not the best way to handle it. So after I talked about what is not good, I just want to try to show you what I do when I build up solutions, either for my own or together with my team. Okay, let's close this one and just add a new element, and now comes something into place which is it's a little bit funny, like the Windows slogan, click on start to shut down. It's the same thing here, click on fun new project to create not a project but a solution. So wording is not the best here, but you can do it. You go to other project types and Visual Studio Solutions, and here you got blank solution. Blank solution is exactly what I want, because when I my solution sample, let's say solution sample, solution sample, I put it in some folder and now I click OK and that's all what I get. Only a blank solution. That's a good starting point for me because what I now have, I have a folder in my file system. Open it. Here, it consists of two files at the moment. When you disable to show hidden elements, it's just one file. I encourage you to enable this one because as a side note, when something went wrong in your Visual Studio in the project management and you don't get the point, just try to delete this freaky Zuo file because it's like a local cache for your solution and sometimes in some certain situations this is what stands between you and your success with solutions. So what you can do when you are a little bit suspicious about this file, you close Visual Studio at this moment, delete this file, reopen Visual Studio and the solution, and then try the operation again which you failed before. And in a lot of situations this works, but just a side note. Now I have a solution sample SLN, okay, and nothing else in this folder in my solution sample. The first thing what I do is I create some certain folders which I know I will need. The first one is a folder I called underline shared. The underline shared folder is a folder, you can name it like you want. Some people name him common or I don't know, point or a dot shared or something like this. But the point is I name it underline so it is at the top of my list. And I name it the way because in this folder I put all the stuff which is not compile stuff, not a project or something like this, but things like text files with some very often needed informations, then an element which will be looking a little bit later, and all the stuff which is shared for this solution I put in here. Okay, another common folder is new solution folder is a logic. This takes all the business logic elements in my solutions. So the other one, let's go a little bit further, is test, and then I have one obviously which is called UI. The test folder takes all unit and load and I don't know what tests, and the UI folder takes console applications, WPF, web, things like that. Okay, so if I got this, I will come to my first element inside my solution, which is surprisingly not a new project. And I have to explain this. In former times, like I don't know, 5 years ago, I was a little bit nervous in creating projects, let's tell them like that, and I created them and I had a solution for the structure, everything was good. And then I recognized that I first of all had to discipline myself, and the first thing was that I created folders in file system corresponding to this structure. Okay, let's do it. Shared, it's a manual step and it's annoying, I know, but it's helpful, as I told you. Logic, new folder, test, and another one which is called UI. This is my convention. You can name it like you want it. My and my team's convention. So now the first element, the real element inside it, would be inside the shared folder, and it's solving the what I call assembly info problem. The assembly info problem only takes place in solutions with like 10 or more projects. And the problem is that, for instance, in the assembly info, you have informations like the version of a project. The point is that inside a solution, in my case, often the first three parts of a version, like 1.2.5, like are shared between the solution. This is crap when I do it the old way, because when I want to upgrade like the minor version, I have to step through all my assembly infos or do something like XSD or tricks like that to just update all projects to this version, to this main version. The other way is I just have to type, for instance, my company name and my assembly product all over again. If I create a new project, I just have to type all the stuff, copy and paste it from my other project. It's annoying. So I searched for a solution, and there is one. Built in into Visual Studio, you need nothing but the following. First of all, you create a file which has to be named shared assembly info. Actually, I don't know if it has to be named exactly this way, but I name it this way because all samples at MSDN use this convention. I don't know if it's necessary, just try it out. So shared assembly info lays inside the folder shared, as you can see. Now, the next thing that I want to do is I create, will show you how do I do. Let's add a new project. We will get rid of it soon. Let's go to Visual C Sharp and take this one, and it's not, it's just because I want to show you a default assembly info, this one. This is just, let's clear this. Okay, we don't need comvisible in GUID. You only need it in certain circumstances. I just leave them out. I just make an enter here. The namespaces are not valuable for us. Company would be, let's say, coding freaks in my sample. I know. Product will be a solution sample. I just tell you more about this. Here is something like coding freaks. And here the trademark is, in the most cases, the same as the product because I do or I don't have a trademark. The culture is not so necessary because I'm not culture specific, and the configuration is not so available too. So when I look at the remaining parts of the of an assembly info here, I just recognize that this part is unique for each of my projects. It's changing. But this part stays all the time the same if I follow the convention, for instance, to mark the version this way. There's another good hint to use an alternative to file version. It's called assembly informational version. And you can just read about it if you like to at the MSDN. So, which means this part is corresponding to the first three of this, and there will be the revision. It's placed automatically by the build process. Okay, let's look at this sample now. And this part, as I told you, is the static one, which doesn't change from project to project. So I take this part and I copy it out, copy, and I go to my shared folder and edit this file and put in this one plus the namespace, because it's a normal C# file. It's nothing nothing cool about it. So that's all. I close my editor, and now I have here all this stuff inside this file. What I now do is I just remove this project out of my solution because it's not interesting me, and I have to be careful to delete this folder too. Bye-bye. So now I have a shared assembly info, and I just created this console application to paste out the assembly info part, which I don't have in mind. Now, the next thing is very straightforward. I click on the solution folder and say, hey, add existing item. I go to this folder, shared, click on it and add it. Okay, that's it. Now, the shared assembly info is part of my solution. That's good. I can reference it. Now, do the next step and create our real first project, add new project. But be careful. First of all, I want to take a class library. And the main thing now, as you created your directory structure, is to hit browse and go into the logic folder, which you just right-clicked before. Okay, And be sure that you don't put this new project just in the root directory. Makes no sense. And now, I would encourage you to create some sort of convention for naming your project. My convention is, I just use the folder name as a so as a prefix. I use the solution folder name, logic in this case, followed by a dot, and then my first project mostly is called core in my samples. It's the core logic of my project. So this is very important, and I wrote about a bug in Visual Studio since Visual Studio 2013. The importance here is to use a prefix if you will create later on a core project in UI, test, or other folders too. Because in former versions you could do that and add references between them, but since Visual Studio 2013 this is not possible, because project names have to be unique to be able to reference them between each other. Okay, just a side note. Now I have logic core in sample logic class library. Okay, let's go ahead. This is my project. I just get rid of this class 1, we don't need it. And the main trick is now, we did nothing special at this moment. We have a shared assembly info which lays around here useless in the shared folder, it does nothing. And we have our assembly info, which is the same, excuse me, crap as before, and we won nothing. Now the next step is important. We right-click logic core and say add existing item. Add existing item. Now we go to our solution root folder, go to shared, and just one time click on shared assembly info, hit the arrow and on the add button, and use add as link. Add as link just adds a reference to this file into this folder. Right now the convention is that this file, this shared assembly info, has to lay at the same level as the assembly info of your project. So now we can just move it to this level. If you now ask me if I just did not add it right direct to the properties folder, it's because the properties folder is a special one and has no add opportunity for me. That's why I just first added it into logic core and then I moved it into its properties folder. The next step is I can get rid of all the stuff which is already handled by this file. Just let me put them side by side so you can see. On the left side you have my project assembly info, this one. On the right side you have the one which comes as a link from the shared folder. I don't touch this. I just put in logic core, okay, and just this contains my core logic. Yeah, good comment. Description. Describing a word with itself. So anyway, I just did it, and now what happens if I hit build on logic core? Success, which is good. Now let's go into our folder, logic, logic core, bin, debug, because I built in debug, properties. Properties now says all the stuff that I said, it's language neutral. Here is my trademark, it's in German, but believe me, it's called Marken. So we have a product version, we have the file version with the revision at the end. We have logic core and all the stuff we need. That's good. It's getting even better. This first step is a little bit, you know, a lot of put it there, move it to this position. And if you add more projects, let's do it. Let's add a test project. Add new project. Remember to hit browse and go into the right folder. And then just let's use the unit test project and let it name test.core. Test core. So now we have test core, and now the step is very simple. Just clean it. You don't have to do the add baba and move it to this. You just take the link from the other project and move it now or copy it to the properties. That's because you're just copying a link. So that works. And now we can do assembly info, get rid of this, get rid of this, test score here. All my tests collected. That's not too. So if I now build this one, and I did nothing more than moving a link. Where am I? Solution sample, test score, bin, debug, oh my god. So, I have all the stuff, version information, things like that, and it's okay. If I now want to just raise up a little bit my version, I can click here, and it's no matter where, because it's the same thing, and I just say 1.1. 0.1.1, and I rebuild, for instance, the core project, and now I take a look. It's magically at the right level. I like this, and that's why I showed you. So, anyway, we have this one, and now comes often forgotten part of project creation, and this part is very important in ordering all your stuff together. And you know, Visual Studio, C Sharp, ASP.NET, all this stuff is full of conventions, and other technologies which you don't expect to, they are looking at this convention, and if you follow them, for instance, code analysis, so, or tools which you use like ReSharper, they know about conventions. But if you don't use conventions, that makes no sense. So one convention is, how do I name my namespaces? Let's take a look at, do another sample, add a new project in the UI, and do Windows Desktop Application, a console one, browse into the UI level, and then say UI.testConsole. Now all the stuff, just to repeat, move or copy to this position, go here, remove this, remove this. It's not all day stuff, just a simple test UI. So the problem now is that this namespace UI test console could be in another project of mine too. It could be in another solution example the same namespace, and the reason for namespaces is to make types unique into unique containers, so that the full qualified name of a type is unique worldwide, if you will. So what I have is a convention for creating namespaces, and my convention is, just let me new file, and just to show you, text file is cool. My convention, oh, I'm German, so I write convention with K. Convention would be my prefix. I just tell you more about this. Dot, then solution name, because this is my product name. Then solution folder. Oh, that's not good. Solution folder. Then project name, but without solution folder part. I just show you an example. And then maybe some other thing which I will talk later about. So what does it mean for the program file? So my prefix is, in every project I do for Coding Freaks, is DE, because this is my top level domain, Coding Freaks. So this is simply to ensure that if for some reason someone on the world will call his product solution sample 2, this would be unique anyway. Because if he names it DE Coding Freaks, I sue him, or I just write about him on my blog. I don't know what I do. But it's a good point to make it unique. Now the prefix is done. Let's go to the next one. Let's go to solution name, which is solution sample. Okay, that will be the next part. Now, solution folder, which my project sits in, it's UI. And now the project name, but without UI, because I already have it, so test console. That would be my namespace for everything which lays right behind, right beneath the this project. And because I want this, I go to the properties of my project, and I go into this default namespace and just paste it in. That's my default namespace for this project. And when I now open up the program file, because I have ReSharper installed, a tool for convenience, because I have this, ReSharper recognizes, hey, he wants the convention to on the namespace, and he's not following his own convention here. Namespace does not correspond the file location. Should be Okay, cool. So in ReSharper, I can, instead of typing it, click on this one and just say, hey, move it. I'm too lazy. And he moves it and removes all the unnecessary namespaces which I don't use, blah, blah, blah. The main point is now I have this namespace. And that's very important for me, because now, even in my namespace hierarchy, when I call DE coding freaks, oh, solution sample, yeah, you're right, UI, everything makes more sense. It's on the third level logical. The first one, solution, the first is the solution structure, then the file structure on the directory, and then the namespace structure, which I consider very important. I have to do the same stuff menu in all projects. This is test core, test.core. Okay, cool. And now, as you can see, I just take this part with the solution, and I just go and use this one, just put it here in the place, and that's it, logic core. So it's not some logic core, it's a logic core of solution sample, which is developed by me. That's another point. So, when I have this, I just prove that you can reference project each other, add reference to solution to logic core, let's say, and now I have logic core, and it's very clear that I'm referencing this logic and their core. That's cool. Set a startup project, no problem. So, and should work. I like this approach, clear and very consistent approach. And I recognize that a lot of people don't know how to do it, in which order, and so I just wanted to show you. Another thing which is rare shown is that you can right-click solution and go to properties, and that is a dialog which is very unique. Because it's solution-wide, you can do things solution-wide, which you can't do in other dialogues at all. For instance, what we have here, there is some sort of tail that when you are developing a solution which contains two console projects, let's say a server console and a client console, which is a very often used sample, you need two Visual Studio instances to debug this stuff. That's not true. You just need this window. You go to multiple startup projects, and then you can say, hey, start please this one and this one, but without debugging, and do it in this order. Something like that. You could do it. And if you hit OK, by the way, no project is bold, because now you have multiple startup projects. So if you don't see any bold projects, you know you have to go to properties. Back to single startup. Now, what's interesting too, what I think is, for instance, configuration. Configuration can be, or configuration setup can be very, very confusing and very, very time consuming. If you use this window, a lot of steps are a lot more easier to do, because you can open the configuration manager, yeah, can add configurations here like you do it all the time, and then you can, as on the solution level, decide which project to which configuration and platform. Another very similar thing is code analysis. Not all people use code analysis. I do. Some people know it as FXCOP. And on this level, you can decide, no, I don't want to use the recommended rules. I want to use the Microsoft All rules here, as you can see. So, and now you can see it at one place that all rules are set or not set. And you just scroll through big projects and you see, oh man, here, this project is something different. That's a very important point when I talk about solutions too. And I won't show the integration into TFS. I think most people can imagine what I talked about at the beginning. I would encourage you to invent some sort of convention for you and your team. Just discuss it and use it all the time, because it's very easy to find things, and it's proven in big projects. And hopefully I could help you with this.